What happened to Amir Ali? Amir Ali has left the meeting. So today's my topic is free trade versus protection, protectionism. So we have seen the international scenario of balance of payment, balance of trade, capital account, current account, and how to balance the disequilibrium of balance of payment and all. So in the second module, there is a topic called free trade versus protection. Now we can look what are the distinctions between free trade versus protection. So first of all, protectionism is the restriction of trade with other nations in order to protect domestic firms. Free trade is the elimination of barriers to trade to create large open markets for goods and services. So the protectionism and free trade are two concepts. Free trade is a part of globalization, but protectionism is anti-globalization. So protectionism is against the globalization. So you know what is globalization? Globalization means one world, one market concept. There is no boundaries among the countries. There's a free trade, free flow of capital, free flow of labor, free flow of material across the countries. So that is a concept of globalization. So globalization means the free trade. There is an institution which promotes the trade, that is the World Trade Organization. So World Trade Organization is an autonomous body which promotes free trade among the countries. So there is two policies. These two are the policies by the countries. A country can take a policy of free trade, or a country can take the policy of protectionism. So if a country can take the policy of free trade, it is the elimination of barriers to trade to create large open markets for goods and services. That means that country is fully favorable to the globalization, the free export and import. There is no restriction on import as well as exports. But protectionism is the restriction of trade. So all the import and exports are being restricted. So protectionism in detail. Protectionism protects local firms. So why a country adopt a policy of protectionism means the country always protecting the domestic or local firms from international competition. So if a country adopts free trade, international competitors will come. You had examples, right? In the telecom, mobile telecom sector, earlier we had only one BSNL. So and after 1991, economic policy was announced by the Manmohan Singh, and there was a privatization on the telecom sector, and many companies came into the field of telecom, like Hutch, Vodafone, Idea. So foreign companies also came. And after that, there was a competition, and the cost of telecommunication system were reduced. So the international competition will lead for the disturbance or destruction of the domestic companies. So protectionism protects the local firms from international competition and economic change, such as technological innovation. As such, it is often politically popular, as people may feel that other countries are taking jobs. So still there are countries may feel that if if we promote the internationalization or globalization, some other new firms will come up to the country, and that will they will disturb the domestic firms, and that will destroy the domestic firms. So that concept is protectionism. So that a country can take a policy like protectionism, they don't want export, they don't want imports. They're just taking care of the domestic firms only. The country with extremely strong protectionist policies will need to produce its own goods and services as imports are restricted or made prohibitively expensive. So there are policies by the country as a part of protectionism. That means a country restricting import as well as export. So restriction in the form of taxes and quotas. The country heavily charge export duties and import duties to disturb the export and imports so that a country can promote protectionism. This tends to be incredibly inefficient as countries have competitive advantage and weaknesses. Such a country is unable to export product where it is strong and is required to produce goods in areas where it is weak. This may result in the economy stagnating or regressing while the rest of the world advances. So, but that country is in a dilemma, like you know that a country did not get an international exposure because no other countries can come up to that country, or that country cannot export or import goods from the other countries. So that country cannot get the international exposure or international competition or international competitiveness. So they are in alone. They are alone, and they don't get international exposure. So that's the basic problem of protectionism. So next is free trade. Already I explained that there is no restriction on export and imports. Now we can look on the free trade versus protectionism. So strong protectionism tends to lead to economic declines. It may also lead to wars, as international trade is one of the major factors that forces nation to get along. A nation which isolates itself can expect to become less competitive over time against countries that face up international competition. But free trade is economically beneficial. However, the benefits may be distributed unevenly, leading to social unrest. Free trade agreements can lead to race to the bottom, whereby countries need to cut wages and regulations to stay competitive. In many cases, free trade may also have negative impact on culture and resilience. In theory, free trade agreements could be structured to protect quality of life, the environment, and resilience. See, protectionism on the other side, protecting the domestic country firms and restriction on the international firms coming to that country. But free trade means the trade is become free. Anybody can come into the country and they can trade. So the domestic firm need to compete with the international firm. International firms coming to the country, and the domestic firms need to compete with the international firms. That is free trade. So both are moving opposite direction. A country have the authority to decide whether they need protectionism or whether they need free trade. So both things have advantages and disadvantages. Okay. So this is the difference among protectionism and free trade. Definition. Protectionism, restriction of trade with other nations in order to protect domestic firms. So it's full restriction. No other firms or no other country coming into the scenario of the domestic firms, or no country attack the domestic firms. But the free trade means elimination of barriers to trade, create large open markets. That means anybody can come into the nation. Examples of protectionism means imposing taxes like tariffs, import quotas, administrative barriers, trade legislation, subsidies, exchange rate fixing, etc. can be imposed as a measure of protectionism. These are the weapons for the protectionism. But free trade, free trade agreements, the countries take the free trade agreements. Like you might have experienced, you might have heard about that. There are a lot of free trade agreements, ASEAN, NAFTA. So these kind of agreements create or promotes the international trade. So I will show you one paper. That paper already been shared in the group. So you can look on the paper. Are you able to see the paper?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the paper, Protectionism and Free Trade, A Country's Glory or Doom. This paper was written by Regina Adelaide Nugvo-Fodo, and this is an international paper. It was published in the International Journal of Trade, Economics and Finance in 2012. So this paper deals protectionism and free trade, which one is good, and this paper critically examines the advantages and disadvantages of protectionism and free trade. So the abstract of the paper, if you read that, this paper does not only go over the ground of the generally traversed and examine the arguments commonly used, but it carries an inquiry further than controversies on either side. So you see, I already said that both things have advantages and limitations. So these advantages and limitations will be explained in the later stages of the paper. In the introduction stage, you can read that the free trade explained. Free trade and one paragraph for the free trade and other for the protectionism. Free trade is a system in which the trade of goods and services between or within countries flows unhindered by the government imposed restrictions and interventions. That means free trade means no hindrance of trade, means anybody can come to the country and trade. So interventions include, the usual interventions include tax, tariffs, non-tariff barriers, such as regulatory legislations, quotas. These kind of things are completely removed in free trade. So free trade opposes all such interventions. One of the strongest arguments for free trade was made by classical economist David Ricardo in his analysis of comparative advantage. You already studied the comparative advantage theory. If a country can benefit something like labor, the country can utilize the benefit of the cheap labor in the country. If a country have benefited for the, like the material is cheap, the other countries can take the benefit of materials. That is a comparative advantage country. So the opportunity cost can be saved through the theory of comparative advantage. So the comparative advantage theory always promotes the internationalization or globalization. So free trade will be benefited with this theory, comparative advantage. So the countries going or the firms going for the internationalization or globalization for getting the benefit of comparative advantage, as the Ricardo rightly explained the comparative advantage theory. So the protection of human, that the domestic industries, the concept of protectionism. So protectionism is also an economic policy of restraining trade between nations through methods such as tariffs and imported goods and services and restrictive quotas. Variety of other restrictive government regulations is designed to discourage imports. So this protectionism is also a policy adopted by the country to protect the domestic firms as well as domestic industries, so that they have imposed high tariffs, high quotas, high export duties, high import duties to for the removal of internationalization of of the country. So this policy is closely aligned with anti-globalization. I already explained the protectionism is a part of anti-globalization. This term is mostly used in the context of economics. Protectionism refers to policies or doctrines which protect business and living wages within a country by restricting or regulating trade between foreign nations. So there is an economist called Adam Smith. He famously warned against the interested sophistry of the industry seeking to gain advantage at the cost of the consumers. Virtually all modern day economists agree that protectionism is harmful in that it costs outweigh the benefits and that it impairs economic growth. So the majority economists criticize the thing of the concept of protectionism. Protectionism is harmful to the country for the development. So there is next is the country's protectionism blooming glory. Some countries protection, there are favoritism, there are favorable approaches to the protectionism. Some countries were benefited or some countries are benefited out of protectionism. So that the protectionism is a blooming glory. A country's protectionism will mean that protection of home countries or infant industries till their growth. So if the country's domestic domestic firms as well as domestic industries are in a position of growth, then the country can go for the free trade. So till that time, the country would stick on the protectionism. That is one approach. So similarly, there are similarly, there are negative approaches to the protectionism. Protectionism as a fatal failure or the death of protectionism, extreme protectionism leads for the death of countries. So, no nation has all of the commodities that it needs. So, no countries will be like abundant resources. Some countries are shortage of resources. Some countries have some resources are abundant. So some countries are abundant in certain resources. For example, take the case of Colombia and Brazil. They have ideal climate for growing coffee beans. The major coffee producing countries are Colombia and Brazil. But take the case of US. US is a major consumer of coffee. You know, the US people are the major consumers of coffee. They wanted coffee rather than tea. So the thing is, US is a major consumer and Colombia and Brazil is the major producer of coffee. So if these countries promote protectionism, the coffee will not be sold in US, and all the coffee produced by the Colombia and Brazil should they have to consume it. But it is very difficult to consume the entire coffee produced by Colombia and Brazil. So the countries will be in a very difficult position. So if these countries adopt protectionism, so that the economists are telling like the countries definitely go for the free trade policy rather than protectionism, so that the Colombia and Brazil can easily sell the coffee to the US, because the US people are more likely liking the coffee. So Consequently, this has made Colombia and Brazil big coffee exporters and the US big coffee importers. So this free trade created the situation like Colombia and Brazil big coffee exporters. In other words, if the countries go for the protectionism, these coffee producing countries like Brazil and Colombia will not get benefited out of the selling coffee to the US. So now they are the biggest producer of coffee, but there is a biggest consumer of coffee by the US. So this is the major problem of protectionism. So what is needed is export and import shall be promoted to get the benefit of all the countries, consumerism as well as protectionism. So there are a lot of debates, a criticism for the protectionism has been pointed out this paper. So you can read the paper and find some more limitations and criticism of protectionism. So this paper clearly stated the benefit of protectionism as well as the the negatives of protectionism. And the next thing is free trade policy or no restrictions or taxes on its import and exports. So here it is mentioned the practicing free trade as an advantage. The literature analyzing the economics of free trade is extremely rich with extensive work having been done on the theoretical and empirical efforts. So it creates winners and losers. The broad consensus among the members of the economics profession in the US is that free trade is a large and unambiguous net gain for the society. So there are a lot of favorites for the free trade. You know, you might have experienced, India have experienced after 1991, new economic policy was announced. Before that, we were in a troubled situation such limited products, only Indian products were available. So now we can have many options, to take options like Indian product as well as international product. We can buy a laptop from Indian companies as well as American companies. This is possible. So we have Apple mobile phone, we have Apple Apple computers, we have Chinese product, we have Indian product, we have Japanese product. So these products coming through this policy of free trade. So that all thing you can read, the advantages of free trade. And there is a negatives also free trade. Some domestic industries were hamly disturbed or destroyed through this free trade. There are many examples. Many Indian firms were destroyed. The best example is BSNL. BSNL were troubled, and the last year, 90,000 employees were retrenched in one day because of a troubled situation of BSNL. They are struggling. Sometimes we call it, I would like to say, surviving in a troubled way. So there are negatives associated with the free trade. Sometimes the domestic firms are very weak and they are not in a position to fight with international firms. So acute competition in the field of every field. So the domestic firms need competitive strength to fight with the international firms. That is a major drawback of free trade. So there are case studies in this paper. You can read the paper and understand the thing of free trade and protectionism. So this paper will be helpful to understand the concept of protectionism and free trade. This paper explained the advantages of protectionism and disadvantages of protectionism, and advantages of free trade and disadvantages of free trade with cases. Okay, so any doubts you can ask me right now.
Sir, ഈ പ്രൊട്ടക്ഷനിസം ഫോളോ ചെയ്യുന്ന ഏതെങ്കിലും കൺട്രി ഉണ്ടോ?
Protectionism, the old policy was protectionism. Now the WTO came into force. After WTO came into force, many countries were joined as a member of WTO, World Trade Organization. The main purpose of World Trade Organization is promoting international trade. So I think already 45 countries are the members of WTO. So the total countries in the world are 195 countries. So around 150 countries are members of WTO, and nearly 40 countries are not yet get the membership of WTO. See, all these 150 countries are promoting the international trade, including India. So there are 30 to 35 countries. They are in the stage of protectionism. That means something like they have good kind of resources, so they are confident about, they don't want to go outside. But in the long term, this causes disadvantages to that country, because the competitive spirit and competitive strength will be diminished because of this protectionism policy. So you read the paper, and the papers are important. you take any topic I have given the assignment, and you can refer the assignment with the help of papers. If you read the papers, you'll be able to understand the positives and negatives of that concept. Okay. So there are papers associated with your assignment. So you can download a paper and read it. Then you will be able to understand the positives and negatives of paper. I would like to say that it will be a good strategy is to prepare assignment and seminar. So if you look on the contents in a book, that just say the contents only, but you will get a criticizing or critical approach while reading the paper. Okay. So any more questions with this free trade and protectionism? No more questions, we can wind up the class. Today, and any other classes already announced?
No, sir.
No classes. Okay.